today we're doing two things. We're showing off two new things that we've done. Is we've created a 8.1 liter crate motor package, and it's got our NRE dual throttle body X-Ram intake on it. So this is 496 cubic inches. It's 9.8:1 compression. We got a really small hydraulic roller in it. And it's a streeter. It's a nasty streeter, which I love. But the nice thing about it is it's something that you get a small block footprint with better than big block torque. And what we're gonna show you today is this at 496 cubic inches makes more torque than a 572 big block, like what you would buy a GM crate 572. It's making 696 peak foot-pounds, and it's making 600 foot-pounds at 2,800 RPM. So the like average torque band of this motor is so insane, and the throttle response is just insane, that you basically have almost 700 foot-pounds, 690 horsepower, hydraulic cam, no adjust, piss pump gas. It's a bad dude. Okay, so what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna test the 496 LSX with a real potent motor and a real good intake manifold, and then we're gonna do a backup test with the X-Ram and give you guys a comparison.
So you can tell it's a nasty little small block. But what I want to point out is the actual throttle response. That's a big, it revs good, but when you compare it to the X-Ram, you really see the difference. So I want to show you the rev. So it sounds good, but when you compare it, you'll really see the difference.
Okay, so we're doing a start of pull here, 2,800. You got 520 foot-pounds at the start of the pull with a 670 foot-pound peak, which is the best it's made, with 635 horsepower at 5,800 RPM. And your average data is 618, 520. So, one hell of a strong LS. For this inches, the horsepower is not all that strong because it's got a small hydraulic roller in it, and a big inch motor, and it's starting to run out of air with this intake manifold. In general, just because it has a small cam. But so there's your horsepower number, 520 at the start of the pull, 670 peak, 635 horsepower peak. Okay, here's another pull, 513 foot-pounds at 2,800, 669 foot-pounds, 1669, a little more horsepower, 635 a little earlier at 5,300, 630 down by 6,000, with an average power number 615, horsepower 517. And we're looking at the average here just to kind of give you a view. We'll go into graphs later, but there's a good, little
shot of what we got going on right there. So 669 and 637. So here is the test with the X-Ram, and you can see this is at 2800, just the massive torque difference. You know, 608 foot-pounds already at 2900, 692 peak foot-pounds on this pull, which we've been as high as 695, 689 horsepower, and still hanging on pretty tough at 6000. So, but what really needs to be shown here is the average data of 657 and 551.
Just want to show you some of the bitchin' features. We've got twin 90 millimeter throttle bodies going through the new NRE X-Ram. It's got a tall deck GM block. We've done custom camshaft, custom lifters, 4.5 inch stroke crank, 4185 bore, but it all stock LS mounts, stock bell housing, stock drive unit. You can literally bolt this in your car and have big block power with an LS footprint, but actually better than big block power. And as you'll see when you listen to the video, it's just nasty. As one of my guys here, Dave, said, it sounds like it's you're sitting in the pits listening to a pro stock, but it's not. It's running on piss, and it's a street car.
Okay, so what I've done here is I've overlaid the two dyno pulls on top of each other. So this is the best pull with and then one of the better pulls with the X-Ram. And so you can see right here, this is at 3200 RPM. Now right here, this is where the f*** is, and you can see this ginormous torque bubble area where just how much torque this thing is making. I mean, this entire curve, it narrows up a little bit and then gets bigger and stays ahead the entire time. Never in the power band is it less, but the low speed is just so huge. I mean, 80 to 90 numbers better on an intake swap, no other changes. So and then as you can see on the top here, the green is the horsepower, and it's, you know, consistently ahead all the way, you know, and this is almost 50 numbers better in the end there. So it's an interesting way to, another way to look at it here.